What's up, guys? It's Bion from Mental Health Nation. I'm a fourth year medical student and a future psychiatrist with a passion for your health. So this video is about how to literally make your brain bigger and better. And this specifically entails how it can boost your memory, boost your learning from the inside out. So you may have once heard that you were born with a certain amount of brain cells or neurons, and that was it. You couldn't make any more for the rest of your life. So if you lost any more, you were pretty much done with. Well, that idea has since been outdated. Yes, it's true, you're born with most of your neurons, but as you age throughout your life, not only will your brain cells continue to change their interconnections within each other, this is called plasticity, there's actually new neuron creation throughout your life as well, specifically in certain parts of the brain. One of these parts is the hippocampus. So this is a part of your brain associated with learning and with memory. This region will be the star of the show today. So wouldn't it be cool if we knew exactly how this process happened? Or more specifically, how we can actually make this process happen? Luckily, we do. The answer, BDNF. This stands for Brain-Derived Neurotrophic Factor. Now, this may sound super scientific and complicated, but we're gonna make this as simple as possible, okay? It's a protein that essentially turns brain stem cells into new neurons. So this process is called neurogenesis, the making of new neurons. This has actually been known as stem cell therapy for the brain. And this has been documented in many, just the gamma of neurology. And the main part that's been researched is the hippocampus. And the hippocampus is actually one of the first regions, if not the first region, that's affected in Alzheimer's disease. This BDNF has actually been shown to be low in people with schizophrenia and depression as well, okay? So this has major clinical potential. So here's three of the biggest tips you can find to try to increase this BDNF in you and help promote some cell growth and brain health, okay? So the first one is exercise. Not only are there nerves or nerve cells in your brain, but your muscles actually need nerves to contract. So at the junction of the nerve and your muscle is something called an end plate or a neuromotor junction. Key here is BDNF is also expressed in your muscles at this junction. And this is one of the reasons why exercise has been shown to be beneficial for both brain health. So to give a clear-cut example, UCLA shows that any person undergoing any kind of aerobic exercise has a 50% less chance of developing Alzheimer's. So why would this be? Well, according to our BDNF model, exercise will increase your BDNF levels, and BDNF levels increase new neurons, specifically in the hippocampus that's associated with memory loss. Another example is I remember when I was studying for the MCAT, the tutor used to tell us to exercise as much as we can. Not only does exercise increase the blood flow to the brain, but it could increase the neurogenesis in the memory and learning parts as well. So if you have more neurons with the capacity to learn better and to memorize better, is just inherent and intuitive that you would be able to score better on exams. I said previously that low BDNF levels can be associated with depression. Exercise has been known to be an antidepressive itself inherently. So this is an example of how exercise can actually boost your mood and be antidepressive as well. So what type of exercise should you be doing? Specifically, it's aerobic exercise. You want to maintain 60-70% of your max heart rate for about 30 minutes. This is the ideal time that's been shown in studies. And also, ideally, you want to exercise outside because the sun may also increase these BDNF levels. So there was a study in the Netherlands where they took serum levels of this BDNF. Throughout the summer, people's BDNF would actually go up. Tip number two is coffee. So coffee, or the caffeine in coffee, does three things to your brain. Number one, it increases your brain metabolism. So the speed of processes going on up here will actually increase. Second, it increases the production of different neurotransmitters, dopamine, serotonin, and norepinephrine. And thirdly, most relevant to this talk, is it increases BDNF. So drink up your coffee. It's FYI, it's a highly pesticide-rich food or crop, so try to get organic. The darker the better, the more antioxidants it'll have. And to protect as much of that goodness, try to ground it yourself at home. More of this BDNF is actually concentrated in the coffee fruit versus the coffee bean, so the fruit's what surrounds the bean. This is not really yet commercially available, but it's expected to start being commercially available by April of 2017. Real quickly, other things that show promise for increasing this BDNF is probiotics like yogurt, kombucha, kefir, omega-3s. So you can get omega-3s from fish oil, from hemp seeds, from chia seeds, from flax seeds. And spending time with friends and family has also been shown to be beneficial in this regard. So as mice, the more they're in a community, the more these BDNF levels have been shown to increase. Tip number 3 is actually lowering your load of high glycemic carbohydrates. Okay, so sugars in particular have been shown to lower BDNF. With that, I'll wrap up. If you found this helpful, please subscribe. Until next time, peace.